I told my boss, it ain't no limits. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limits.
Put your
head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in
the
game.
I'm whipping the track off with messed up suspension. I drove it so fast that I blew out the engine. I kept it too real ever since the beginning. I play offensive D, I might switch my position. La mama was thirsty, so I had to quench. I'ma drive real fast, cause you know I shoot quick. Just like Travis Kelsey, I be having emotions. Just like the lamb, I ain't know I'm exploding. My heart cold, bad, I ain't got emotions. I'm going hard, yeah, you know I'm devoted. We running streets, yeah, you know we control it. She love the kids, she be busting it over. I'm quarterbacking like I'm Kyler Murray. Trying to win, I'm up at practice early. Going crazy, I just ripped the jersey. It's the first half, and we done dropped 30.
We just up the score on them, boy,
man. I told my boss, it ain't no limits. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limits.
Put your
head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in the game.
Money on my mind, head in the game. It's like I scored again, diamonds on them dance. I can hear the music playing with the band. Crowd going wild, dived in the fans. I'm locking in on a mission, I'm telling my vision. You young as you get like me. I got that shirt that she with me, I gave her a jersey. I told her to join my team. It's best you go where it's safe, you know how I play. I get to a sack like Frank. You can teach money to fly, I turn it hot. I catch it and go to the bank. It's crazy, I'm used to the lights, I'm shining so bright. It's visor to cover my face. You see me working and working, I'm getting it done. And soon they be feeding me grapes.
I told my boss, it ain't no limits. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limits.
Put your
head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in the game.
They screaming my name when I walk in the building. Yellow diamonds on me like I play for the Steelers. I'm in the field, yup, just like a Steeler. Oh, this your girl, my bad, had the Steeler. I hop on the beat and I float like a river. I caught a TD, yeah, right across the middle. I'm speaking banks, boy, you telling riddles. Can't hang with the gang, so we had to sit them. We're down. I'm in LA, right around and around. My dog just called safe in a touchdown. When I call a play, do I hear a sound? Hold up, hold up, hold up. Money calling right now. I gotta go and get it, and it don't matter how. All I know is, man, yeah, I'm 10 toes down. I keep my head high and my eyes on the prize. Yeah, my feet on the ground.
Let's go, go, go.
I told my boss, it ain't no limits. Told all my dogs, it ain't no limits.
Put your
head in the game, head in the game, head in the game. Head in the game, head in the game.
Hey, yeah. Turned up, turned down right now. Two dope, make bad to get around right now.
The next level was legend. You gotta have accomplishments. In any league, they considering me dominant. The long falls, you know the pit of defeat, bottomless. I was hungry way before I got your support. I hopped off the porch around the time that y'all got awards. Lyrical exercise, this what I call a sport. The fourth bar, brother, when I push the rock off the court. I got champion genetics. Champion genetics. Next level. One of the best. Remember me. You seen the making of a star, they hear my name and remember me.
Remember me. I am the player.
Just let the record show that I said I'm coming for everything.
I am the player.
You seen the making of a star, they hear my name and remember me.
Remember me. I am the player.
Just let the record show that I said I'm coming for everything. The cat and mouse whose talent don't average out. If your flow ain't nowhere near this caliber, that don't count. Competition get flattened out. Getting money like I went top three in the first round. My salary that amount. They want my style, but that ain't much to be flat about. I take it as a challenge when rappers calling my status out. One of the best, and they ain't my pedigree. You can have the rings, or we did an AI's legacy. I got champion genetics.
Champion genetics. Next level.
One of the best.
Remember me.
I am the player.
You seen the making of a star, they hear my name and remember me.
I said I am the player.
Just let the
rep the show. That I said, I'm coming for everything.
I am the prayer.
You seen the making of a star, they hear my name and remember me. Just let the record show that I said I'm coming for everything.
My God, oh God, this is on a God level. The sun, the sky, you can see the vibe. We ride the high, always on a high level. So open up your eyes better.
Why these tell me? You can join the journey, you is worthy. Just allow me, no. Kicking down your door. Bloodsuckers, I see this industry is filled with sheep. People that pretend to be something that they will never be.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Tonight, it's a good Week 9 matchup here on a Monday night between the New Orleans Saints and the Chicago Bears. Of the regular season down. What will the final two bring us as we're off in Week 9? And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. To Montgomery to begin the drive. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. An ideal beginning of the drive there as they'll get 20 and a first down. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead them to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity. And that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week. And right now, we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. 36 yards on the play.
Things are looking pretty darn good on this first drive, aren't they? Came right out, set the tone, this time with a big pass play.
And if the peek behind the curtain that they gave us or their game plan, I don't think that's going to be the last one we see.
I think you're exactly right about that.
Herbert operating from the red zone. There's Evans again, complete. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. And he's already got 2 catches on the opening drive. They know he's going to be a handful.
And sometimes you game plan for that offensively. You want to make sure that guy touches the ball. And sometimes it just happens naturally. And then you change your game plan. When he has the hot hand, you keep going back to him because he's running routes with confidence.
And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. David Montgomery, his 5th rushing touchdown now on the year. And the Saints put the Knights' first points on the board as they take the early lead. Point after, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0.
Saints 7, Bears nothing.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away.
And here's Jakeem Grant from his end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result, and he opted for the touchback. Fields and the Bears now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. So the drive's going to start with Pollard. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. In motion left is Watkins. On second and 11 now. Fields over the middle, complete. That's Watkins. So the completion good for 7 there. And it's third and 4 now. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
Always important as a defender on third down to keep the play in front of you and make sure you don't give up enough space that they can make a move on you in the open field. Try as he might, he wasn't able to get to the first down marker. Excellent defense, good tackling.
This is away and a very good kick angled for the sidelines. No returning this one. It sails out of bounds, and they'll spot it right at the 20. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And they entered play on a two-game win streak, and then they've got the open date on their schedule next week. So this is a group that's really looking to hit the break on a high note.
And this will obviously be a tough game for them, but go ahead and play this out with me, partner. If they win here and make it 3 in a row, they get to heal up after that. You've got to think that's an ideal setup and a worthy goal to play for in this one.
So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Now Herbert with it, looking to pass. He'll get this to his tight end. That's Pat Freiermuth. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards.
Well, as a coach, you absolutely love seeing your offense find their rhythm early, and that's exactly what we've seen so far. They had a touchdown on their opening drive, and now they connect here for another nice gain for a first down. This offense is moving the ball well, exactly as he drew it up in practice.
And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. 63 yards rushing for him now as he has gotten the night off to a hot start.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sack.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
After the sack on first down, Herbert going up top. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play. But sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one, weren't able to do so.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Montgomery. And they're going to move it down inside the 25.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. And the first play will be a field goal try. From the right hash, it's a 41-yard attempt. And his kick is indeed good. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
The ball upright on the tee, and the Saints kick team booms it away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. Nothing for them yet from an offensive standpoint. Down 10-0 as they come up first and 10. They'll run with Pollard to begin the drive. And he's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, 2nd and 3. They'll fake the handoff. Now Fields. Got a man. It's Tyquan Thornton. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. First catch for him. It's good for a dozen and a first down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage. So timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first.
And it's a fumble.
Wow, that ball is not free. But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover.
That was a nice grab. Just couldn't get the feet down, right? You need that toe tap sequence there. Whatever size shoe he's wearing, probably need about a half size smaller to complete that one.
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Swinging this out for Pollard. And he gets this to the 48, but no further. Well short of the line to gain. That'll bring up 4th down. They wind up getting 8 yards, but they needed more than that. Here's A.J. Cole now to punt this one away. And he gets it away, a directional kick going toward the sideline. And out of bounds, sailed over, looked like right near the pylon. This one's going to be perfect. Directional kicking at its finest, right down at the 1-yard line.
Brandon, you're never quite sure what the side judge or the field judge is going to rule there. That was awfully close, but in the end, he says it passed over the 1-yard line, and that's where they're going to mark it out. I mean, you can see it right there, right? See him walking up the sideline? Told him to stop right there at the 1.
They'll start on the ground with Montgomery. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Just 1 yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Well, he got what he could there, just trying to move forward and gain a little bit of yardage and create some space. You know the pressure is going to be tough defensively.
Here's 2nd and 9, just 1 yard on that last run. From his own end zone, Herbert. He completes it to Evans. They'll wind up getting 7 on the play, and that'll leave him with a 3rd and 2.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
Third and two, Herbert. Look at Mike Evans' way again, and he's got another one. And he is going to have a Saints first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, things are definitely going right for them here in the first half. Pick a down, any down, even third down, no problem. They get a connection there and pick up a fresh set of downs, continuing to move the ball.
On first down, Justin Herbert. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Kind of a fine line when you're setting up the screen. You don't want to throw it too early to have the defense react too quickly. And you definitely don't want to throw it too late. And that way it's not formed perfectly. Got to make sure you hit it just right.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Again, Herbert airing this one out for Evans. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest. With a guy with that type of speed, you do so. Send him deep, try to throw some air under it, and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
Going to throw on third down with Herbert. Oh, he rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked off by Isaiah Rodgers. If you combine last week and this week, he's got a hat trick going because he had two interceptions a week ago.
He's seeing the ball so well and understanding where receivers are and positioning. I mean, just watching him work with such great technique and paying it off by actually catching the ball.
Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. Christian Watson with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Bears have cut it back within a score. Tucker with the extra point, and that'll cut it to 3 at 10-7. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Well, partner, fast forward with me for a second. Remember, next week they have the open week, so they're going to get some extended rest. Does that change how they manage the rest of this one?
I think it does a little bit, but not by too much, because you're right. You get the extra rest, you get a chance to heal up and kind of, you know, do a little bit of a reset for this team. But it's also 7 extra days to think back to the last time you were on the field. So now, a little more importance on what they're getting done because they carry it with them for essentially 2 weeks.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
Different pass rushes are designed for different things. Sometimes you want to keep the quarterback in the pocket. Sometimes you want him to flush. I don't know exactly how this one was designed, but they made sure they moved him to his right. He got out of the pocket. Unfortunately for him, he was hit as he tried to throw the ball, and that resulted in an incompletion.
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. First catch for him. It's good for a dozen and a first down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
2 minutes remaining in the first half, 10-7, our score. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. The gun, Montgomery, and just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Looking to throw on second down. Herbert, he finds his target. It's Evans. And this winds up a pickup of two, maybe two and a half, to about the 39. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of, until they stop him, why not go back to him? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Here's Herbert. Finding Evans here, going across the middle of the field. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. On first down, it's Herbert. Looking for Evans, and it's intercepted. And the Bears are going to have the football here at their own 35-yard line. He's at it again, Charles. He had the pick six last week. Not a pick six here, but an interception.
That's another Oski, because that's the word we use when we intercept the pass. Oski tells your team to rally around and block for you. Well, that worked really well last week because he had made it all the way to the end zone. This week he got the Oski, maybe not a touchdown, but, boy, he's playing really well.
Meanwhile, Fields' throw taken in by Thornton. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. On first down, Fields. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts, as he'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
On second down, it's Pollard. And he's going to be brought down at about the 33-yard line. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. Now the offense will burn their third and final timeout. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. New Orleans adding some depth to the secondary. They've got six DBs out there now for third. Trying to run for it with Pollard. A gain of eight and a first down.
Even though they gave up more than they wanted to on that play, it actually illustrates how well they bottled him up throughout the game, because that was his longest run of this contest.
Here's second and 10. And they'll bring the big tight end across the formation left. Now Fields. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
Well, every point certainly counts at this stage of the game. But after driving so far, you absolutely know they want to finish it with six instead of three.
Tucker's kick is good, and that will notch up at 10. So the defense able to force the interception, and the offense working their way to field goal range and able to get three out of it.
Yeah, and give them credit for that. They took the ball, maneuvered it downfield, and while they couldn't get exactly what they wanted, which was a touchdown, they did get 3 points out of it. So they paid off what the defense gave them. Both sides to be thrilled with that.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And with only 4 seconds on the clock, time likely for just one snap of the football. And he's going to lose yardage, not that it matters, as the final seconds tick away. So thanks to the late field goal, we are all tied up heading to intermission as we send you down to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. On the return from his end zone is Grant. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. It's a tie football game here. What do you think, Charles, the message was at halftime?
Well, I think that they probably just looked at things and said, we're fortunate that this is a tie game. No need to panic. No need to change a whole lot. We didn't play anything close to our best in the first half, so we don't have to go out and win one for the Gimper. Let's just go out and play our best football and win one for us.
Second and 9 now from the 21. They run straight ahead here with Pollard. And it's been like this all night long. Nowhere to run as they stop him behind the line. On play action, Fields. On the sideline, did he keep his feet in bounds? They say yes. Great job, both feet in, first down. 21 yards there on third down.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down in bounds, toe tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
Play action. It's Fields. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. They don't get the hookup there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's the perfect word for it, precise. Because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, let's face it, it's not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
Pollard going to try the right side. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
And for the Saints here on third down, an extra defensive back on the field. Fields now to throw. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jordan Poyer. And the Saints are in great shape here as they take over at the 46-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days.
That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
To Montgomery on second down. And he's got some space here. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 88 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here.
Okay, let's do our version of name dropping here. Let's show off a little knowledge, right? The A-gap, the gap between the center and the guard on either side, right? Both sides. Control that, you're going to control an inside running game.
And he had to feel satisfied because he hit that gap, broke the contact. He loves that.
That's the best part, right? That's what he's going to ask the coach to run back on film.
Let me see that one more time.
Do that again, coach. Look how my legs kept churning. I just kept moving, and he did to the tune of a big game.
Montgomery. Fighting, but he won't get too far. Maybe a yard. That's all down to the 2. No gain there, and it's going to set up second and goal. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
And now third and goal coming up, the loss on second down. That just means this crowd's going to get even louder, and they'll get a little bit of extra help from the defenders as they exhort them to join them in the effort.
They'll run for it with Montgomery, and he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
And I know this quarterback, his instinct, he's going to want to go for it here on fourth and goal. I want to see if the rational heads on the sidelines prevail, and they say this late in the game, let's get three in the lead. This debate is going to be fun.
And his kick is good, and they will take the lead at 13-10.
Whatever was said in the locker room during the break must have worked. They forced the turnover. They didn't get the touchdown, Charles, but it does translate into 3 points to begin this second half.
Exactly as they discussed in the locker room at halftime. Get some points to get things kick-started. Now start your half off with some momentum. Gives you something to build on for your next possession.
The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive.
And we'll see if they can bounce back from that last drive. In particular, if they can bounce back at the quarterback position, Charles, after throwing their first interception of the ball game.
Yeah, and some guys, you know they're going to want to try and get a big play right away and take control back. Others, they're going to look to hit a couple shorter passes, get a little momentum back that way.
But for the defense, that goal's not changing a bit. They want another pick.
You're exactly right about that. In fact, you've got to watch them a little bit because in coverage, they may cut down their gaps a little bit, maybe their splits a little bit in order to try and get to the ball even faster.
So the completion good for just three. And it brings up third and five now. They'll need five on this play to move the sticks. One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. The offense on third down tonight, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be third and five. Fields. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. They'll go with Pollard here on first down. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. Tackle made by Rasheem Green. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run. The best runs for the top running back, those are the ones you focus on and want to take away. And they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
On third down, it's Pollard. A gain there of 12 yards and a first down for the Bears.
Brandon, this can be so demoralizing for a defense. They've had two opportunities to get off the field. They haven't gotten it done. So now your coordinator, he's going to call every blitz that he has, any type of exotic, something that they haven't seen before. And he's also telling the defensive linemen, don't worry about holding people up. Just get in gaps and try and make a big play.
And not only not getting off the field on two opportunities, clock continuing to run.
On first and 10, here's Fields. He's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
Finally hauled down for the first time this game. Multiple defenders in there to drop him.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. Second and 24.
On play action, Fields.
He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And that
will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
Trying to erase that deficit all at once. One big shot. He took it. Unfortunately for him, incomplete.
A field goal from this spot likely out of the question. They've got to get closer here on third down. Fields going to keep it running left. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. A rough go there on third down, a loss of four.
Well, they certainly didn't appear to be fired up about their options throwing the football. So, to me, this seems like a case of just kind of taking their medicine there, run the ball, see if they could pick up something. Instead, they were throwing for a loss.
So here comes Justin Tucker in a big spot. And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. Well, not too long ago, Charles, that would have been a new NFL record. But instead, it's shy of setting the record, which is 66, but still from 65 away, one of the longest kicks in league history.
And that puts him in elite company in the NFL. Only a few have ever even attempted that, let alone put it through the post. How about his moment? It came together for him, and he delivered.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And we essentially have a brand new ball game. After that last field goal has tied us all up, we brace for what should be an exciting rest of this fourth quarter. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play. But sometimes an incompletion is the right play. And he showed that he's learned from his earlier interception on that throw. Instead of forcing it, he just tossed it away.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Here's Herbert. This is caught by Evans. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards, the final tally.
And partner, in a tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars. And he came through with a nice catch right there.
And it looks like this will be the last play before the two-minute warning. Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. The run with Montgomery. And a solid run here as he'll pick his way down to the 42-yard line. 96 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on.
That's exactly what they were looking for. If they get another gain like that, they'll be right there in field goal range.
And the tension building. Down they run again. Here's Montgomery, and he can only manage to get a couple. Second and eight coming up. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Throwing
Herbert. And this is going to be intercepted. Does the big boy have the juice? Pass the 20. And they will score a pick six for Bears touchdown. In a tie game fourth quarter, that's about as big of a defensive play as you can possibly make.
And it didn't happen by accident. That was scouting right there. They've seen things that have happened before. They knew in certain situations the type of plays they like to run. Read it, and were able to go after the football, get it, and take it into the end zone for a touchdown for themselves.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. Now remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick six, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
Yeah, and sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick six and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
Herbert. Able to get this to Patrick, and he's brought down. They took a big shot there. It pays off. A solid gain downfield. A gain there of 30 big ones. The big play has him all the way out near midfield for a first and 10. The slot man in motion right. Now Herbert. Delivering a pass here to Evans on the out route. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Herbert to throw. And that's intercepted yet again, and that could be the backbreaker. Picked off by Isaiah Rogers, and the Bears have just about sewn up this football game. Agreed, that's twice now in this fourth quarter.
As a quarterback, a lot of times you think it's all on you to make plays when you're losing. And here, the play's not there, but he throws it anyway.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Down to a knee here. The defense still with a couple of timeouts. We'll see if they want to use it. In the win column for the Chicago Bears, and they were spurred on by a strong performance in that fourth quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game, but when you throw one in the fourth quarter, that tells everyone that you're getting stronger and dominance is starting to take over, right? The way that you close, the way that you finish, that gets preached to you from the time you're playing Little League football all the way up through, and they closed them out with a big-time performance down the stretch.
So for Chicago, the win will move them to 7-2 now on the year. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Arizona Cardinals. Meanwhile, for New Orleans, the loss will drop them to 6-3 now on the year. And they're going to get an extra week to stew over this as they're not back in action until week 11.
boys make major moves. Still the same ones that I came with. Up in a payment, told you we nothing to play with. Guess some things unchangeable. Me and my thirst insatiable. Tell we all big time. Face on my rollie on big time. Face on my goals, that's a big climb. Still my flow is unshakable. Run it up, I cannot quit it. I need it, I ain't where I wanna be. I can admit it. Never submitting, I'm fighting my darkest of thoughts. I am a force. I harbor the light that's inside of my heart. I write in my art and give you my story. You are the witness. I came on a mission to give you my pain and give you my glory.
All this time, I'm on the grind. Oh, I'm shining. Nothing can stop me. All these years, blood, sweat, and tears. But I'm still here. Nothing can stop me. Run it up. 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 Nothing can stop me. Run it up. 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 Nothing can stop me.
I overcame all the odds. I ain't been playing it safe, nah. I was just giving my all. I'm taking it there. Hop in the Wraith and we lay in the stars. I made a habit of bars, yeah. I was just playing my cards. I'm taking it there. I'm taking it there. I'm taking it there. It's gonna be a riot, doubt me, it's quiet. I got the can of gas, I'm about to ignite. I am driven, I won't ever get tired. Cause I've been left behind, I have to get right. Waiting on the sign, nah, I just wait on myself. Got nothing weighing on the mind. One thing I learned after all this time, the mountain you carry meant for you to climb.
All this time, I'm on the grind. Oh, I'm shining, nothing can stop me. All these years, blood, sweat, and tears. But I'm still here, nothing can stop me. Run it up, run it up, run it up, run it up, run it up. Nothing can stop me. Run it up, run it up, run it up, run it up, run it up. Nothing can stop me. Nothing can stop me.
Keep it up, pop out in black. This bun on my knife, I'm